Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. O King of Israel, Hosanna in the highest. Bless, O Lord, we beseech thee, these branches of the palm tree, and grant that what thy people today show forth corporally for thy honor, they may perform spiritually with great devotion, and by ardently loving good works, may at last gain the victory over their enemy, through thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth God, world without end.
Amen.
Thou shalt purge me with hyssop, O Lord, and I shall be clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. When they drew nigh unto Jerusalem, and were come to Bethphage, unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, Go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied, and a colt with her. Loose them, and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, The Lord hath need of them. And straightway he will send them. All this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, Tell ye the daughter of Sion, Behold, thy king cometh unto thee, meek, and sitting upon an ass, and a colt, the foal of an ass. And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And the multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. At this time, you may come forward and receive palms. You can take as many as you like, and then these will be placed out in the parish hall if you want to take some home with you. When we're all done receiving the palms, I'll ask my son to put this in the parish hall for me. Okay?
Thank you.
Christ, our King and our Redeemer, in whose honor we have carried these branches while chanting thy solemn praises. Mercifully grant that thy grace and heavenly benediction may descend wheresoever these branches shall be taken, and by thy mighty power defend those whom thou hast redeemed from all assaults of the enemy, who with the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit livest and reignest God, the world without end.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Be not thou far from me, O Lord. Thou art my succor. Haste thee to help me. Save me from the lion's mouth. Thou hast heard me also from among the horns of the unicorns.
My God, look upon me. Why hast thou forsaken me, and art so far from my help, and from the words of my complaint?
Be not thou far from me, O Lord. Thou art my succor. Haste thee to help me. Save me from the lion's mouth. Thou hast heard me also from among the horns of the unicorns. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
in the second chapter of St. Paul's epistle to the Philippians, beginning at the fifth verse. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven, and things in earth, and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Thou hast holden me by my right hand. Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel, and after that receive me with glory.
Truly God is Lord unto Israel, even unto such as are of a clean heart. Nevertheless, my feet were almost gone, and my limbs have well nigh slipped. And why? I was greedy by the wicked. I do also see the ungodly in such prosperity.
My God, look upon me. Why hast thou forsaken me, and art so far from my help, and from the words of my complaint? O my God, I cry in the daytime, but thou hearest not, and in the night season also I take no rest.
And thou continuest holy, O thou worship of Israel.
Our fathers hoped in thee, they trusted in thee, and thou didst deliver them.
They called upon thee and were opened. They put their trust in thee and were not confounded.
But as for me, I am a worm and no man, a very scorn of men, and the outcast of my people.
All they that see me have me to scorn. They shoot out their lips and shake their heads, saying,
he trusted in God that he should deliver him. Let him deliver him, if he will have him.
They stand staring and looking upon me. They have my garments among them, and cast lots upon my vesture.
Save me from the lion's mouth. Thou hast heard me also from among the horns of the unicorns.
Oh, praise the Lord, all ye that fear him. Magnify him, all ye seeds of Jacob.
They shall be counted unto the Lord for a generation. They shall declare his righteousness.
Unto the Lord thou shalt be born, whom the Lord hath made.
Thank you. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew. When the morning was come, all the chief priests and the elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. When they had bound him, they led him away and delivered him to Pontius Pilate, the governor. Then Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, saying, "I have sinned in that I have betrayed innocent blood." And they said, "What is that to us? See thou do that." And he cast down the pieces of silver to the temple and departed, and went and hanged himself. And that chief priest took the silver pieces and said, "It is not lawful for them to be put them in the treasury, because it is the price of blood." And they took counsel and brought with them the potter's field, the field of blood unto this day. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremy the prophet, saying, "Then they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him that was valued, whom they, the children of Israel, did value, and gave them for the potter's field." And it's the Lord upon me. And Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, saying, "Art thou the King of Jews?" And Jesus said unto him, "Thou sayest." Accused of the chief priests and the elders, he answered nothing. Then Pilate unto him, "Hast not how many things they witnessed against thee?" And he answered him to never a word, insomuch as the governor marveled greatly. Now at the feast, the governor was wont to release unto the people a prisoner whom they would. And they had a notable prisoner called Barabbas. Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, "Whom will ye that I release unto you, Barabbas or Jesus, which is called Christ?" For he knew that for envy they had delivered him. And when he was set down on the judgment seat, his wife sent to him, saying, "Have thou nothing to do with this just man? For I have suffered many things this day in the dream because of him." And when the chief priests and elders persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas and destroy Jesus, the governor answered and said unto them, "Whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you?" And they said, "Barabbas." Pilate saith unto them, "What shall I do with Jesus, which is called Christ?" And they all say unto him, "Let him be crucified." And the governor said, "Why? What evil hath he done?" But they cried out the more, saying, "Let him be crucified." When Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather atonement was made, he took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, "I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See ye to it." Then answered all the people, and he said, "His blood be on you and on our children." Then released he to Barabbas to them, and when they had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus unto the common hall, and gathered unto him the whole band of brothers. And they stripped him and put him on the scarlet robe. When they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, the King of the Jews." And they spit upon him and took a reed and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put on his own garment and led him away to crucify him. When they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. Him they compelled to bear the cross. And when they were coming to a place called Golgotha, that is say, a place of the skull, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. When they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, and they parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down, they washed him there, and set upon his head the accusation written, "This is Jesus, King of the Jews." Then were the two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and another on the left. When they had passed by, reviled him, wagging their heads and saying, "Thou that destroyed the temple and builded it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross." Likewise also the Son of God came down from the cross. The chief priests, mocking him with scribes and elders, said, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be that King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusteth in God, let him be delivered now, if we will have him. For he said, I am the Son of God." The thieves also, which were now crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour, there was coming the darkness all over the land. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, saying, Eli, lama sabachthani? My God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, this man called Elias, and straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar, put it on a reed, and gave it to him. And the rest said, "Let it be. Let us see whether Elias will come to save him." And Jesus, when he cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And behold, there the temple was rent from twain, from the top of the bottom, and the earth did quake, and rocks rent, and the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints which had slept arose, and came out of the graves after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. Now when the centurion and they that were with him watching saw Jesus, the earthquake, and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, "Truly, this was the Son of God."
The only begotten Son of God,
begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated. Good morning. It's great to see everybody. I hope you're all doing well. And welcome to everyone watching online. It's great to have you with us. A couple of quick announcements to go through. You can take some more poems home with you if you want. They're in the parish hall. Please only take what you need to use, because I do have some folk who are not attending in-person services who will want to come in during the week to collect some for themselves. So we are going to relive the very strange situation we had 2 years ago where we ran out of poems. Kind of a good problem to have. We had so many people. But still, I don't want to push it. But that being said, go ahead and take some more. Feel free. I hope that makes sense to everyone. Well, now that I've got you all thoroughly confused, let's continue. We have birthday blessings to Kathy Hebert. Her birthday is today, March 28th. And anniversary blessings to Tony and Kathy Hebert, March 30th. Join us for our Holy Week services this week. We have Holy Communion Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday at 10 a.m. These are the traditional prayer book Holy Day services. Today we heard St. Matthew's Passion. On the next days we hear St. Mark and St. Luke's Passions. And then on Friday we hear, of course, St. John's Passion. So come on out for those. Our Thursday we have Holy Communion at 10 a.m. for Monday, Thursday, and evening prayer at 6:30. Friday, we have, for Good Friday, our solemn service at noon. So normally our services are at 10, but Good Friday we're having it at noon here at the church. And then we have evening prayer and Stations of the Cross at 6:30 p.m. Saturday, Easter Even, we have morning prayer and the Anti-Communion at 10 a.m. And then we'll decorate the church for Easter and finish up at noon with evening prayer. So I will email that out to everybody. It's also on the website, and I hope you all can make it out. Thanks to everyone who's been bringing out donations for Community Action Food Pantry. As you know, this month and next, we are collecting personal hygiene items. But, you know, that being said, if you want to bring them food, that's fine too. And just put it there in the yellow bin in the parish hall, and we'll get those out to the people. You can also bring in Easter candy for the kids. So if you drop by something by the church this week, especially if it's Easter candy, let me know, and I'll let Karen know, who is taking the items from here to the pantry. And then, of course, we're participating in the Amanda Hitch catalog. We're nearing our, I think we're a little over the halfway point of our fundraising for Cancer LifeNet at Kauffman Cancer Center. You can sign up and join as a walker for Team St. Albans at uchfoundation.org and make a small donation, and that will help support that wonderful organization. We're not walking together as a group out at John Carroll this year, but rather on that day, if you take your and walk for Team St. Albans. So if you have any questions on that, please see Christy or give her a call, and she can answer them, all of your questions for you. And I think that's it as far as announcements go. Are there any other ones that need to be made? Okay. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Today begins Holy Week, the most important week of the Christian year. I hope everyone was able to read the article in the newsletter where I tried to explain aspects of the different Holy Week services and traditions. If not, please do so, as I trust you will find it both edifying and interesting. And if you don't, you can have a full refund for that issue. The two most important festivals in the church calendar are Christmas and Easter. And it's fascinating how at both we hear the story of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. How that story around those times of year prepares us for those great feasts. So as we all know, the story of the triumphal entry of Jesus is the gospel reading for the first Sunday in Advent. And now, here today, it forms the core of what we call the Liturgy of the Palms. But whereas in Advent, the story paves the way for the Holy Nativity of our Lord, here during Passiontide, it prepares us for his glorious resurrection, which we celebrate next Sunday on Easter Sunday. What is interesting is that the version of the triumphal entry that we hear on Advent Sunday includes with it the story of Jesus driving the money changers from the temple. After his triumphal entry, he goes straight to the temple and he trashes the place. There's the people there who are buying and selling, you know, the sacrificial animals and things like that, and it says that he went and overturned their tables and made a whip and chased them out. He completely trashed the place. Now, what he is doing there is symbolically destroying the temple. It is a symbolic destruction of the temple. You see, they can no longer, at least for that brief period of time, get the animals and stuff, the little doves and things like that. You know, it's all a big ruckus. You can just kind of picture it, you know, all these birds flying everywhere and I don't know what else, you know, running off. Come back here, you turtle dove, you know. So they can't buy and sell anything and they can't have the sacrifices. He is destroying symbolically the temple. Now, why is he doing it? He is declaring it to be redundant because he is now the temple. His body is the temple. And I mentioned last week in the sermon, maybe at the early service, how that passage in I think it's St. John's Gospel, where he's looking at the temple and everyone's saying how magnificent it is. And he says, if you destroy this temple, I can rebuild it in 3 days. And he said, you can't rebuild this in 3 days. It took decades and decades to build this. And then John's Gospel says, but the temple he was talking about was his body, this temple. And he's talking, of course, about his death, burial, and resurrection. So Jesus is now declares the temple to be redundant. It's no more, it's not necessary, because he is now the temple. He is the way to the Father. The temple was the way with all the sacrifices that the Hebrew people had access to God and atonement for their sins and so on. Jesus says, that's done. It is fulfilled in me. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. John 14:6. So here now in Holy Week, we hear the story of his triumphal entry into Jerusalem once again, but without that little add-on story of the money changers in the temple. We should, however, remember that in the events that we commemorate this week, Jesus is going to accomplish what he symbolized in that event in the temple. He's going to fulfill his vocation and offer his life on the cross as a sacrifice for many,
And in that tragic event, which he willingly accepted, he opens the gateway to heaven and finally reconciles God and man in a way that the old sacrifices of the law only foreshadowed. We heard in St. Matthew's Passion the following verse. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom. The veil was this big, thick cloth. It's not like a little, you know, a drape or something like that. It was very thick. I think I read somewhere that it was, I mean, several inches thick, maybe almost a foot thick, I think I read once. And it's miraculously ripped in half from top to bottom. And what it did is it separated the holy place in the temple from the most holy place, or the holy of holies. So the holy place in the temple was where the priests did certain ritual actions. You had in there a big candle stand, like a menorah, that was light. You had a table of what was called showbread, and you had incense there. And it's interesting, when you realize this, it makes sense of a lot of what Jesus says in some of the Gospels. He says, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. So he's slowly, you know, drawing things away from the old church. The old dispensation is passing away. And now, when Jesus dies on the cross, the temple that separates the holy place from the most holy place, where the Ark of the Covenant was kept, and where the priest went in once a year to offer atonement for the sins of the people, that has now been ripped in two. That has been ripped in two, and now anyone can go in. Jesus dies on the cross. The veil that separated God and man was torn asunder. And this meant that old religious system that God gave to the Hebrew people had finally been fulfilled in the person of Jesus. So the old forms and all the minutiae of laws and regulations that went with it were no longer needed. Jesus did them all in man's place. So from thenceforth, all people who put their faith in him and believe in him could be saved forever through him. And therefore, the old temple was indeed destroyed by Jesus' death on Mount Calvary, rendered useless by the one effectual death of him whom all the sacrifices of the old covenant only foreshadowed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Thy rebuke hath broken my heart. I am full of heaviness. I looked for some to have pity on me, but there was no man. Neither found I any to comfort me. They gave me gall to eat, and when I was thirsty, they gave me vinegar to drink. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
Thank you.
and glory of God, for all of those on our parish prayer list, those whom we mention in the secrecy of our hearts, and for all the faithful departed in Christ. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen.
We offer unto thee, O God, Father Almighty, the paschal sacrifice of the Lamb without spot, by whose blood we beseech thee to deliver us from the ravages of the destroyer and to lead us safely into the land of promise. Through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
He who truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying, and worth of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Eat. This is my body, which is given for you.
Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion.